Hello students, welcome back to the next session of Basic Electrical and Electronics Engineering. I, Professor Prithish Ubute, I am going to discuss about a topic known as a DC circuit, and today in this particular session I will elaborate a concept of two different theorems applicable for electrical engineering, that is nothing but Thevenin's theorem and superposition theorem. Please note that these theorems are quite useful and significantly used in network simplification, network analysis. What is network analysis? First of all, network analysis is nothing but a mechanism or method of identifying or calculating a current or a voltage across any specific element. For example, in my circuit, if I have one resistor R1, if I wanted to calculate how much amount of a current is flowing through R1 or how much amount of a voltage is getting dropped across resistor R1, then these type of a theorems are used to do that. So that is nothing but a network analysis. In fact, these theorems can also be used for network simplification, because this theorem will replace a network with some simplified version of that particular network. In fact, there are many different theorems available to do that, like Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, superposition theorem and so on. So here I am going to confine myself to Thevenin's theorem and superposition theorem only. In this session I will only tell you about the statement or definition of this theorem. In next session we will discuss about and how to solve a numerical using Thevenin's theorem or superposition theorem. Now see, this is the definition of Thevenin's theorem. One diagram summarizes everything. See this particular diagram carefully. Any linear bilateral network containing several EMF sources and resistances, means because resistance are the linear element, that's why it says that any linear bilateral network containing number of EMF sources and resistance can be replaced by an equivalent voltage source VTH and equivalent internal resistance RTH across a point A and B, across a point A and B. Mind it, why we are saying point A and B? Because we wanted to calculate a current through resistor RL or voltage across resistor RL. So again, the final definition of Thevenin's theorem will be something like this. For the sake of calculating a current through a resistor RL or voltage across a resistor RL connected across point A and B, we can convert a linear bilateral network containing number of EMF sources and resistance into an equivalent circuit containing only two elements, one voltage source VTH and one resistance RTH, where RTH is an equivalent resistance across point A and B, where RTH is an equivalent resistance across point A and B by series and parallel combination of resistance, and VTH is an equivalent voltage across point A and B calculated using mechanism like current division formula, potential division formula, or KVL or KCL. So VTH is an voltage, equivalent voltage across point A and B calculated using any mechanism. So this is the equivalent circuit. Now by applying a simple KVL, we can calculate a current I flowing through a resistor RL, and also we can find out the voltage drop generated across resistor RL. So this is the statement of Thevenin's theorem. One diagram summarizes entire statement of Thevenin's theorem. Now let's proceed to the second, that is superposition theorem. This superposition theorem is not only applicable for electrical circuit, it is applicable for any system as such, because this is applicable for all linear bilateral circuits or all linear bilateral network. See, this is the statement. A current flowing through or a voltage across an element in a linear bilateral network. Up to this particular point, both definitions of Thevenin's and superposition are exactly same. So a superposition theorem says a current through or voltage across a linear bilateral element or element in linear bilateral network is equal to algebraic sum of algebraic sum of currents or voltages produced independently by each power supply if network contained more than one power supply. Very simple to understand. If our network consists of more than one power supply and we wanted to calculate a effect across one particular resistor R1, then let's say this is a V1 power supply and this is an V2 power supply, then what superposition say? We will apply only V1 on R1, we will apply only V1 on R1, and we will calculate the effect of V1 on R1, then we will apply only V2 on R1, we will apply only V2 on R1, and we will analyze the effect of V2. Then whatever these two effects are generated, we will add those two effects together. That is nothing but algebraic sum. So we will add those two effects together to find out the final effect. Here the word effect indicate current or voltage. So for example, if you wanted to calculate a current, so how much amount of a current is produced in R1 by V1, how much amount of a current is produced in R1 by V2. We will add those two current together to find out the final current flowing through resistor R1. Similarly, if I wanted to identify voltage, then how much amount of a voltage is generated across R1 by V1 and how much amount of voltage is generated across R1 by V2, we will add those two voltages together to get an final voltage. So this is about a statement of superposition theorem. I hope you understood both these theorems, that is superposition theorem and Thevenin's theorem. Please note, Norton's theorem is beyond our syllabus, so we will not consider that theorem at this moment. In next session, I will demonstrate you how to use these two theorems to solve a numerical related to Thevenin's theorem and superposition theorem. Till then, please be safe and enjoy this session. Thank you.